What? A hill? Oh, I hate hills!
Wow, Trisha's solar train runs really well! And it's so quiet. We barely heard it when it passed us.
That's what a solar engine does. It keeps the train moving smoothly and steadily, and very quietly. Good for Trisha. And how about that powerful sun?
Hey, Mr. the Other Conductor, did you see that? The solar train was beating us back there. Do you think it could win?
Ha! A train powered by the sun will never beat the rocket train.
Well, I wouldn't be sure of that. It's an awfully sunny day.
Hey, we stopped, I think. I can hardly feel it when this train stops.
We did stop. Excuse me one moment, hmm? I have to take care of something.
There. Oh, Thurston! He must have changed the track so we'd go the wrong way and he'd win the race. When I see him, I'll... Oh,
You know, Mr. Conductor, when I'm upset, Mom and Dad say instead of getting mad, I should think about ways to make things better.
Shiny's right. Is there anything we can do to make it better?
You know what? There is! There's an old time tunnel in this part of the Cretaceous. Follow me, Trisha!
You were right, Mr. the Other Conductor. You did help the other trains. Now the solar train's right behind us.
Yes, behind... What?! What? Another hill? We were slowing down! Oh, no. No, I'll lose!
Buddy and Tiny.
Welcome to our show. So you think you're a tyrannosaur. Let's meet today's contestants, Buddy and Rodney. First, tyrannosaurs are known for their amazing sense of smell. Rita Raptorex is hiding somewhere nearby. If you're a tyrannosaur, you should be able to find her. Ready? Go!
Got her! Great tyrannosaur sniffers, boys!
Next task on. So you think you're a tyrannosaur! Tyrannosaurs have big heads with strong jaws. Which one of you can tear into this tough piece of meat?
Let's chow down!
Excellent eating skills, boys. Now, for our final task. Everyone knows that tyrannosaurs have strong legs for stomping. Which one of you can stomp like a tyrannosaur? There we have it, folks. The answer is clear. Buddy and Rodney are both tyrannosaurs. Thank you, everyone. And join us next time we play So You Think You're a Tyrannosaur!
I guess it's true. We are both tyrannosaurs. We even kind of look alike.
We do. Hey. Since we're so much alike, think you might want to try a run down the slope on my tree board? You too, Tiny.
Really?
Woo-hoo! Oh, I can't look.
That was off the hook, Bud and Tine.
It was pretty fun.
It was great!
Fish catchers, are you ready?
Ready!
Ready, set...
Good luck, dear! Catch a big one!
Mr. Old Spinosaurus, I hope you catch Chester.
Kids, do me a favor. Be quiet around me. I need to concentrate.
I hope the Old Spinosaurus finds Chester. Well, actually, I really want Dad to win.
Me too.
I don't see any fish, Dad. Just a big bunch of fog rolling in.
Whoa, that is a bunch of mist. Here I go!
Okay, where the river meets the sea, I wait until a fish jumps and snag it with my trusty claw. Talk about a winning strategy! Okay, fish, now I'm ready for you.
Mr. the Old Spinosaurus has been just sitting there for so long.
But that's how he fishes, Don. He pretends to be a great big rock.
How can I pretend to be a great big rock with all that yammering?
Oh, sorry.
Chester.
Hi, Dad. Can I fly along with you?
Shiny, I'm glad to see you, but you have to watch the contest from the shore, remember?
Yeah, I just really missed you.
Look! That's the biggest fish I've ever seen! Shiny, you head for shore! I gotta dive for that big old fish! Bye!
Hey? Get him! Ah, it's just a small one. Great! I'm drifting out to sea! Megaraptors can't catch fish out here!
Oh, man! That is the biggest fish ever! I'm gonna win for sure.
You see, Chester?
We sure do, Mr. Old Spinosaurus.
This is a chance of a lifetime!
He's huge!
He's mine!
I caught him fair and square!
He's mine!
Oh, bless my scales and feathers! They caught a Masonia, one of the biggest fish in the Cretaceous!
Of course he is! Here's Chester!
I got him!
No, you don't! You got me!
Bless my 15 decorative horns! It's a three-way tie!
But if it's a tie, which time period wins the classic?
Well, Shiny, the trophy would go to whichever turtle crosses the finish line first.
The conductor's right. It's now all on those slow and steady turtles.
Then let's go see how the turtles are doing.
Great idea.
Look, I'm due.
Come on.
Hooray, you're almost there.
Come on, that's it. Walk, walk fast.
You're in the home stretch.
Bless my spiky tail. We're nearly at the finish line.
Yep, it's a close one. It's neck and neck, as they say.
Speaking of which, I can't help but admire your neck, Pauline. It's all armor-plated and covered with those amazing spikes.
Yes, it is. Thank you. It's armor-plated because Triassic turtles can't retract our heads into our shells like you can.
Oh, you mean like this?
The winner by a non-retractable neck is Pauline Progenichelis.
Really? Didn't we all go across the finish line together?
No, that was right when we retracted our heads into our shells. Talk about bad timing.
Then the winner of the classic in the Jurassic Turtle and Theropod race is the Triassic time period.
Dinosaur. Once upon a time, there was a mom. Her name was Mrs. Pteranodon. Sitting on her nest, she heard a scratching and said,
"Oh boy, my eggs are hatching."
One by one, her kids popped.